Now that the model and the schedules are completed, it's time to think about how to put the drawings on paper. We've already created floor plan, sections, elevation, and detail documents, so now let's add the schedule model views. Open the organizer from the navigator. Show the project map on the left side and the view map on the other side. Select the Construction Docs folder in the view map. Click on the Create Folder icon and name the new folder Schedules. Drag and drop all schedule views from the project map into the new folder in the view map. In a similar fashion, select the Construction Docs folder first, and then create a rendering folder. Drag and drop the two camera views from the walkthrough folder. The list of our document views is now ready. Now let's change the view in the organizer so that the left panel shows the view map. In the right panel, let's click on the second icon named Layout Book. In the Layout Book view, there are layouts and master layouts. A layout represents a sheet of paper that may hold one or more document views or drawings. A master layout defines layout sizes and a grid for placing drawings, and also contains items that appear on all the layouts associated with the master layout, for example, an office stamp or a legend. First, we have to define the sheets of paper we're going to use, so let's start with creating some master layouts. Select Master Layout 1 and click on the Settings button. The Master Layout Settings dialog appears. Here, rename the layout Master Layout A0, which is one size we'll have. Under Size, select A0, ISO, Metric from the list. Set orientation to landscape and click OK. The first master layout is now ready. Let's define another by clicking on the new master layout icon. The new layout should be A0 size as well. Name it Master Layout A0 Portrait, but set the orientation to portrait. Let's add a third one, which will use a grid for placing several drawings on it. Click on New Master Layout and name it Master Layout A0 Details. Display the Drawing Placement panel. Checkmark the Align and Assign Drawings to Grid checkbox. Click on Grid Setup button. Set up a 3x2 grid. Click OK to close this dialog, and then click Create to proceed. Finally, create a layout for the renderings. Set the name to Master Layout A3. Change the size to A3, and modify the orientation to portrait. Click Create. Returning to the organizer, let's first unfold the Stories folder and select all the stories in the list. These story views are too big in a 1:50 scale to fit onto an A0 size sheet. Click on Settings to open the View Settings dialog and display the general panel. Change the drawing scale by clicking on the Scale button and select the 1:100 scale for all the stories views. Click OK. In a similar manner, make sure that the section views as well as the elevations views are set to 1:100 scale. Select the Stories folder in the view map on the left side and drag it and drop it on the layout book on the right side. If any of the layers are hidden, please click the Show Layer option in the upcoming dialog to proceed. Select the sections and also the Elevations folder from the view map, and drag and drop these as well into the layout book on the right. Now we have to determine which master layout the new layouts should use. To do this, simply drag the master layout A0 on the Stories folder and release it. In this way, all the layouts in the folder will use this master layout. In the same manner, drag and release the master layout A0 portrait onto the sections, as well as onto the elevations folders in the layout book. Check the result by opening the folders and selecting the layouts inside. Note that the layouts have been given IDs automatically. Close the organizer. Go to the layout book in the navigator. Naturally, we'll find the same structure there. Check out the different layouts, stories, sections, elevations,